We've spoken before, and it was always your aim to get that first professional deal, wasn't it? How do you feel now?
Oh, elated. Honestly, it's amazing. For all my whole life, I wanted to be a professional footballer, and getting that first contract is just, it's a massive step towards it, but I know there's a long way to go, but just really happy with it.
How can you sort of sum up what you've had to do, all the hard work you've had to put in to get to this point?
You know, there's been loads of ups and downs, as you know, in football. Like, I've had injuries before in the past, and it's just getting over them, still sticking with it, and just believing in yourself, which is massive in this game. And I feel like I've done it well so far, but it just needs to continue.
I think a lot is down to attitude, determination, as well as ability, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, 100%. I feel like I do have a good attitude, and I work 100%, and I always want to be the best I can be. But also just improving on technical ability and everything, it's just going to help me get across that line, hopefully.
I know there's a lot of hard work gone in on your part, and I think that's what's impressed a lot of people within the club. You're that sort of character, aren't you? You're pretty undemonstrative. You just get on with your work without fuss.
Yeah, I wouldn't say I'm a big character in the group, but I just want to get my head down, keep working hard, and just, like I say, be the best I can be, really.
And tell us about your journey to get to this point where you become a professional. I mean, tell us about your background and when you came into the academy.
I joined when I was just 11 years old, so I've been here 7 years now. You know, I've had long injuries throughout the thingy, but coming back and playing up it in age groups and stuff, it's been hard, but it's been good as well, and I've enjoyed every minute of it.
And who have been your particular influences in the academy and outside of the academy as well?
100% my parents, for starters, outside the academy. It's been amazing, but the coaches, everyone every year, have been amazing and just helped me so much throughout the career, and my players as well, my teammates. Just we're such a good collective group and stuff, and it's a good place to be at right now.
And just reflecting on this season, you were involved in the 23s, but the FA Youth Cup unfortunately wasn't quite the previous season where you got to the semi-finals, was it?
No, that was probably the biggest disappointment of the season, to be fair. You know, coming into the season, having high expectations of it again. But, you know, you learn from it, really. Like, you need those low points in your career to then strive to be better.
So. And the under-23s in general, it was a successful season, really, overall, despite the disappointment in the league and in the playoff final.
Yeah, like you say, it's been a really good season, to be fair, and it's a great stepping stone for our careers. But, again, this season, we need to push on and go and win it this time. And that's our goals, really.
And your position, you're a centre-half, but you've played right-back, even left-back.
Yeah.
Where do you see yourself? Do you want to nail down a regular spot in a regular berth?
Really, I don't mind playing, but I'd love to just get into the team, really. Just go and play, make a position mine, probably right-back at the moment, probably looking the most achievable, but at the same time, just being able to play every game is my main goal.
And what kind of player would you describe yourself as for those who have not seen you that often?
I'd say I'm tough, I'm consistent, and I want to be, and I'll always put 100% into it, whatever the score, whatever the situation, so yeah.
Every young player needs to improve on something. What are you looking to sort of enhance in your personal game?
Probably just that continuous mental toughness, just keep pushing for everything, and no matter the scoreline, whatever, just keep going, just working hard, and that should get me far, hopefully.
And just finally then, what is on the agenda now for you and for the team as we moving ahead into 2019-2020?
To firstly perform well in the season again, get good, maybe go for silverware again this season, and then of course personal notes, pushing towards that first team place. But you know, small steps at throughout the season, and then we'll see where it leads.
Ben, thanks for talking to us on Blues TV, and congratulations again.
Thank you very much.